So good afternoon, guys.
Now I'll introduce a few topics here. What about transients? Here the main thing is transients. In last class we dealt about what is transients. So we different for different switching we did. Now in general, transients is regarded as a sudden change in state of network. Sudden change in state of network, or a circuit which are generally indicated by switch operation. So sudden change in state of network. So that network will be acting in some state. That means, what is the state here? For any network, we need to understand the state of network. So specifying that state of network means, in general, nature we have RLC elements. That means inductor, capacitor, resistance. Inductor and capacitor are storage elements. So the problem will be occurred for any, if some circuit having RLC components, there is a change in that circuit. So this RLC storage elements has to release that storage. So here we are dealing about the change in current, change in voltage means here. The state indicates means, for example, if you place an inductor, if an inductor is there in a circuit, so only inductor is there in that circuit. So if an inductor is there in a circuit, it can't allow sudden change in current. So we'll deal about inductor. So if you want to find the response across inductor, VL equal to what? L di by dt. So we always observe here what is the change is current. So the state, that means it allows, can't allow sudden change in current. So if a sudden change is can't allowed in that inductor means, there will be a problem. So the issue a problem. So we deal about that. And again, capacitor means the capacitor, it doesn't allow sudden change in voltage, sudden change of voltage across it. So for inductor, what we'll do? So IC, so current IC will take IC equal to what? C dV by dt. So here the change is what? State voltage. So here capacitor state of change is only represented by current change. Voltage status across capacitor only represented voltage. Sorry, current through that capacitor is indicated by a state of voltage through it. So here, well, in transients, the sudden change of current is not allowed in the inductor. And the sudden change in voltage is not allowed in the capacitor. So these two things have to keep in mind while dealing with transients. Okay.
So this is about. It's also called state variables.
So state variables. So these are all nomenclature we have to know. Here the state variable is what? Current through the inductor. So current through, for this circuit, current through the inductor IL is a state variable. And voltage across VC is the state variable of this capacitor. Now we'll see about order of a circuit. Is based upon the number of energy elements present in any network or a circuit. These elements distributed or is known as order. That means if RC circuit is there, here the energy storage element is capacitor. That means it is first order. RL element is there, that is L is an energy storage element. This is also first order. RLC means so two energy storage elements. So this is about second order. So one energy storage element is there means first order. If two energy storage elements is there means it is second order. Okay. So what we deal in this circuit, is we deal about the current only. In this circuit, we'll deal about voltage response only. That states will be deal in transients here. Now we'll see about a few conditions, but that I'm naming that as initial conditions.